Jody Hoard has already done the setup for her lesson on ancient Egypt. She's reviewed the objectives, strategies, and materials, as well as the concepts of main idea and key details.
So, I'm going to get into my think aloud. All right. Maris and Moon's Egypt by Emily Teeter.
Now she will model the lesson for the students by doing a think aloud as she annotates the text.
When I read this part about woman, it makes me think about something that we recently read. Remember when we read the newspaper article about, from Janet Johnson, she talked about how women were almost equal to men in ancient Egypt. So I'm making a connection, and I'm thinking about what I already know, that women had almost equality in ancient Egypt. So we know Maris and Moon from her beautifully decorated coffin. Oh, a coffin is like, what you guys know what a coffin is?
Yeah.
It's like the box that you use to put a body in after someone dies, right? So we know about her from her beautifully decorated coffin, which is now in the collection of the Oriental Institute. Well, that makes me think about Janet Johnson, who we read about, because I know that she works at the Oriental Institute and she specializes in Egyptology. So I bet she had something to do with that. A single band of inscription running down the front of the coffin records her name and her job title. Inscription, this is kind of a big word, but based on what I just read, it says the inscription tells her name and her job title. I'm thinking that inscription is just like some writing on the coffin. Some writing. And the writing tells her name and her job title. Singer in the interior of the Temple of Amun, a type of elite musician priestess. So it says that more evidence can be drawn from the coffin itself, for its style indicates that she lived around 800 BC. That kind of gives me a time period, 800 BC, and I can compare that to other things I know about ancient Egypt. Okay, let's work on thinking about what we would put in this chart for this section of the text. So as I was reading, I was thinking, what is this basically about? Basically, the part that I just read was about a woman named Maris and Moon. So I think I would say for this one, see if you agree with me. I think I would say this was mostly about a woman named Maris and Moon. Now, here's where you guys can help me out a little bit. Let's look back at the text. What details in this paragraph, in this section, support that idea? Antonio?
The coffin said that she was a singer.
Good. It told us that the coffin inscription said name and singer. Another detail that I can add that helps me understand this key idea is that the style of the coffin was from around 800 BC. All right. Now guys, here's our fun kind of bonus question. Is there anything specific we can infer or figure out about ancient Egypt from what we just read?
That there was a singer in ancient Egypt?
Yeah, that some people, or at least one person, had a job as a singer, right? Good. So that there were jobs as singers in ancient Egypt. Good job, Emily. So just always be asking yourself that question. Is there anything else in this text that helps me figure out an answer to that question? So guys, you were very patient. Now it's time for you to talk. What did you notice? What strategies did you notice I used in my think aloud today? What did you see me do? Gustavo?
Making connection.
When did I make a connection?
When you said connection, equality.
I made a connection to something we read about women in another text, right? We knew something already about women, that they had equality. They had more equality there. Good. Anything else you want to share with us about what the strategies that I used today? George?
Summarizing.
When did I use summarizing?
You said that this is going to be about Maris and Moon's life.
Yeah, it's kind of summarizing, but when I said this is going to be about, it's also kind of something else. Vanessa.
Was it predicting?
Yeah, it was also predicting. Yeah, I kind of summarized that this part was about Maris and Moon, but I also guessed that everything I was going to read after this would also be about Maris and Moon, and that's a prediction. Nice thinking. Very good. All right, guys.